Hello everyone. In our today's lecture of microbiology part 1st for FIBAC class, which is introduction to microbial world, we are going to learn about industrial microbiology, in which we are going to learn the industrially important microbial products or the industrial products which are made by using various microorganisms. Now, use of microorganisms typically grown on large scale to produce different types of products made in the industries. And the industrial microbiology microbes are used to synthesize several products valuable to the human beings. Then those products may vary in the different form. This industry has provided microbial products that have been deeply changed our life and our lifespan. Now, there are various industrial products which have changed the way of living life by using different types of fermentation processes or different types of microorganisms. Like there are various industrial products that are derived from microbes, like antibiotics, enzymes, or different types of microbial biomass, and they are prepared by using various fungi and streptomyces. Now, there are various properties which are useful in which microbes help in the generation of products, like there should spores should be can be easily inoculated. Then the in less cost, large scale production of any particular product can be carried out. Then it is less time consuming, and genetic manipulations or elimination of various pathogenic microorganisms can be carried out easily by using microbes, and large scale production in low cost can be obtained in less time. Now, as we have discussed earlier, there are different types of products which can be obtained by using microorganisms, like microbial cells, different types of enzymes, antibiotics, food additives, even different types of microbial biomass or organic acids, or different types of solvents like ethanol or alcoholic beverages can be produced by using microorganisms. Now, production can be carried out in two different ways, or in two scales, which are primary metabolites and the secondary metabolites. Primary metabolites are the products which are produced during the exponential growth or by birth. Which metabolites are produced? They are primary metabolites. And secondary metabolites are the products which are produced during the stationary phase. Let's not go in more detail regarding primary and secondary metabolites. Now, when we see the industrial production of various products, now different types of fermenters are used for the production of desired product. Now, here are a few pictures of different types of fermenters which are actually used at the industrial levels. See, here you can see the different apparatus which are, this is a type of fermenter generally used in different types of industries to carry out the fermentation process, in which sugars are converted into acids and alcohols. See, now this is the interior structure of a fermenter, and these are few pictures from the various industries. We will Now we will move towards the actual product, which is our first point is production of antibiotics. Now, anti means against and biotics means living organism. Any substance or compound which kills or inhibit the growth of other microorganism is called as antibiotic. And it is generally a secondary metabolites. Now, the antibacterial effect of penicillin was discovered by Alexander Fleming. Penicillin was the first antibiotic which was developed or discovered by scientist Alexander Fleming. Antibiotic is one of the most important commercially used secondary metabolites produced by bacteria, fungi and different types of streptomyces species. Most of the antibiotics are produced by microorganisms, especially by actinomycetes. For example, tetracycline, streptomycin or actinomycin D are the various examples of antibiotics which are used by prepared by using various microorganisms or the actinomycetes. And the some filamentous fungi have the ability to produce antibiotics, for example penicillin or cephalosporin. Now this is the process for the production of different types of antibiotics. In the antibiotics are produced by the process of fermentation, as we have discussed earlier also, where the source or the main agent is microorganism is grown in large scale in the fermenters. First the microorganisms are grown in large scale in by using different types of nutrients in the large scale fermenter plants containing liquid growth medium. Also, oxygen concentration, proper temperature and pH is adjusted and the nutrient level is also properly adjusted, and then the fermentation process is carried out for the actual production of our desired antibiotic. This was all about the antibiotics. Our second important product is enzymes. Now, enzymes are nothing but biocatalysts which enhance the rate of reaction or increases the rate of reaction. And they are excreted into the medium by the different types of microorganism. Now, these may be excreted extracellularly or intracellularly. Many microbes secrete large quantities of enzymes into the surrounding medium. Using this feature of microorganism, many enzymes have been produced commercially. Now, these enzymes generally are used for breakdown of various metabolites or the organic products, and even in the process of metabolism also enzymes play very important role. These enzymes, for example, amylase, cellulase, protease, lipase, pectinase, these are few examples of enzymes, are generally used for food processing and preservation. Then in leather industries also enzymes are used, in paper industries enzymes are used, in various scientific researches these enzymes are used. And as we have discussed that it is a biocatalyst, so to carry out various organic processes it is used to increase the rate of reaction, means conversion of substrate into product. Generally enzymes help to carry out this process at the faster rate, and they are highly specific to the substrate, means they have high substrate specificity. Now, the next important industrial product is different types of solvent. Now, organic solvents such as ethanol, acetone, butanol, or glycerol are produced by using microorganisms at the industrial level. Some very important chemicals that are widely used in petrochemical industries are also used, are also prepared by using microorganisms. These chemicals can be commercially produced by using microbes or microorganism at very low cost low cost raw materials are used as a source of nutrient for the production of different types of petrochemicals or the different types of solvents. For example, microorganisms feed on wood, cellulose or starch. They break down this material and convert it into commercially important products. In the alcoholic or beverage industries, generally the yeast Saccharomyces cerevisiae is used for the commercial production of ethanol. And these ethanol or other products are highly used in different things like biofuels or different agents in the production of butanol or glycerol also. These microorganisms help in the production of these solvents. This was all about the industrial microbiology, in which we have already seen the production of antibiotics, enzymes, and different types of solvents. Thank you.